centurion was redeemed at that moment when he proclaimed, "Truly, he is the Son of God." On Good Friday, my thoughts go to the Roman centurion beneath the cross, witnessing the passion and death of our Lord Jesus on the cross. It was his first Good Friday. Mark 15:39 says, "And when the centurion who stood facing him saw that he thus breathed his last, he said, 'Truly, this man was the Son of God.'" At the beginning of Jesus' ministry, the heavens were opened and God the Father gave witness to Jesus. We read in Mark 1:11. And now, at the end of Jesus' mission, the veil of the temple is torn and a centurion, a Gentile, recognizes Jesus as the Son of God. The centurion seems to have taken the charge of Jesus from his appearance before Pilate and supervised all the atrocities the Roman soldiers did to Jesus. At the end, he stood facing Jesus and proclaimed, "Truly, he is the Son of God." The centurion's coming to faith is the first fruit of Jesus' sacrifice. What might have happened to him when he went down the Mount Calvary to his home through the streets of Jerusalem? Life would have been completely different thereafter. He witnessed negatively the passion and death of the Lord and experienced positively the fruits of the complete salvific action of Jesus on the cross. Centurion was redeemed at that moment when he proclaimed, "Truly, he is the Son of God." He cannot remain the same centurion, because he has seen the Son of God. Anyone who encounters the Son of God crucified has to change his or her life completely. St. Paul could not remain as Saul. And St. Augustine declared after his conversion, "The old Augustine is dead." Have you seen the Lord crucified? If not, go to Calvary and look closely what happened there. You will see the answer to your amazement. You will experience the amazing grace flowing down from his face. If you have already seen the Lord dying for you on the cross, go down to the walks of your life and be determined not to remain the same. No, you cannot be the same. If you judge that you remain the same or the worst after encountering the crucified Lord, you may be a person about whom St. Paul said, "The one who, while holding the form of religion but denying the power of it," 2 Timothy 3:5, you may have to go back to Calvary again and again until he floods you with the gift of faith. If you have met the Lord, that encounter will remain in you to put to death all that is earthly in you: impurity, passion, evil desire, and covetousness, which is idolatry itself, Colossians 3:5. It is because we are crucified with Christ. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the sinful body might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin, Romans 6:6. If you have put to death the old self, you are invited to live a life of the crucified one. "I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me," Galatians 2:20. Today's streets have forgotten the sight of the crucified Lord. It is my turn, your turn, to show him to them. You are invited to begin a life of complete sacrifice. Your life of virtues and holiness is not to satisfy the religiosity in you or to be selfishly proud of your great spirituality, but to further die to yourself so that you can give life to many. Let not the celebration of one more Good Friday leave us indifferent to the Lord who calls us continuously to deny ourselves so that we can embrace Him and the world for Him. He needs us, and He needs us for the life of our brothers and sisters.